Thursday? Thursday? Now I know. You guys are great tonight. Thank you so much. Woo! Yeah! You know, there's a line in that last song, Just the Woman, that really speaks to me these days, and that's, it feels like I may never get home. And that's the God's honest truth, I tell you. This last year, I spent less than 20 days in my own home. Yeah. 20 days sleeping in my own bed. What a luxury. It is really a luxury to sleep in your own bed. Just recently, I had an opportunity to stay for one night in my own bed after a 15-hour flight, and I had to fly out the next day. And I did it just to sleep in my own bed. I woke up in the morning without an alarm clock. It was glorious. I threw the curtains back, and guess what? It was a sunny day in Seattle. That never happened. The dreariest, darkest place in the world, I thought. Anyway, the day was starting out great, and you know, all I wanted to do was drive my car, because I hadn't driven my car in like 6 months, right? So I go out to the garage, I take the garage door up, and throw the dust cover back. Oh, she's looking good. I'm all excited to jump in the front seat, but the key in the ignition starter up. Last time I was home, I left it on empty. I got just enough fuel to make it up to the gas station, but I'm sweating it, right? So I make it. I pull in. I'm pumping. I'm standing outside, soaking up the rays, fiddling with my phone. And I notice that somebody pulls into the pump next to me. I don't think much of it, but I glance up, and it's a man, and he's staring at me. I don't think too much about it, but I go back to fiddling with my phone, and after a couple of minutes later, I look up again, and he's still staring at me. Well, now it feels kind of weird, because I'm wondering, what the fuck does he want? Is he trying to start a relationship, or what? Nervously, I go back to fiddling with my phone, but I can't help myself, right? I kind of glance up, and I notice that he's still staring at me, but now he's pointing at me as well, and he says, I've got every one of your records. That I could deal with. So we got in a little conversation. He was a very lovely man, and he said, yeah, I got everything you did. I said, really? Do you have all my albums? He said, yeah, I got all three. I said, brother, that's amazing that you have all three, and thank you very much, but I have 19 albums. You might be interested in, maybe. He goes, 19 albums, I can't believe it, I didn't know. I was wondering what you've been doing since 1991. I set him straight as to what I've been doing for the last 35 years.
40!
We talked for a while, and after a while he says, you know, Jeff, you may have 19 albums, but you got this one song. Oh my God, you got this one song that had done it for me. It's the song that got me to the other side when I was on the wrong side. It's the song that turned me right side in when I was inside out. I mean, man, this is a 50-year-old man with tears in his eyes telling me about this. So I'm taking his shit seriously, right? I said, brother, that's a beautiful story. And I'm just confused. I don't know what it is, the song that you love so much. What is it? He said, oh my God, Jeff, it's the best song ever. Silence in Tennessee.
Silence Now, Tom.